Good morning, everyone. In the last class, we have discussed the area and perimeter of different 2D shapes. Today, we'll discuss circles. In circles, you all are knowing some basic formulas. We all know circle is a set of points which are equidistant from a fixed point. Plus, we can say circle is a set of points which are equidistant from a fixed point. This fixed point is known as, please tell, if I define circle as a set of points which are at a same distance from a fixed point, what do we call this fixed point? Please tell, we call this fixed point as center. Darpan, I am saying a point, not a line. How you can say it is radius? Okay, it is a center. Fine. So the first thing that we study about circles is the circumference. And the formula of circumference of a circle is 2 pi r. You must have studied in the previous classes also. This pi thing came into existence because of these curved surfaces. You must have seen wherever you will see a curved figure. This figure is curved, if you see. In the case of square, in the case of rectangle, we have edges which are flat. But in this case, we have curved surfaces. And as soon as we have a curved surface, this will come into existence. Whether you deal with circle, sphere, cylinder, cone, whichever figure is having a curved surface, that figure will use pi in the formula for sure. You must have observed this thing. Perimeter and circumference are similar things, but for curved figures, we choose these kind of terminologies to make it easily understandable. So, how can we make pi in computer? Ananya, in computer, while you are using MS Word, you can go in the symbols option. In that symbol option, you can write that pi word from there. Okay, or if you want to make it easy, you can type in Google and from there you can copy it and paste in your Word file. That will be easy. Now, circumference is done. Second thing that we study is area of a circle. This also we all know. Area of circle is pi r square. Now, what if I make some changes to this circle? What if I cut this circle in two parts and make it like this? The center is still O and the radius is still R. This is known as a semicircular arc. Semicircular arc. And another way is to cut a disc like this. You must have seen CDs and DVDs. If you cut a DVD in two parts, you will get a semicircular disc. But if you cut a bangle in two parts, you will get a semicircular arc. Are you able to understand this thing, class? Please tell me. Are you able to understand the difference between an arc and a disc? Okay. Now please help me with the formula. Okay, so we have this thing, circumference. We have to find in this case as well as in this case. Please tell, what is the circumference of a semicircular arc of radius r? What is the circumference of a semicircular arc? Please tell. Okay, Arshul, I will try. Till then, you can use the website syllabus that will be followed. Okay, Pranjal is saying pi r, fine. Krishna is saying pi r square upon 2 plus diameter. Okay, pi r square upon 2 plus diameter, fine. Others, please try. First, tell me of this one, then we will go to that one. First, tell me of semicircular disc. What is circumference of semicircular disc whose radius is r? Please tell what is the circumference of semicircular disc. Ananya is saying pi r. Fine. Half of 2 pi r. Okay. Joel, you are saying the same thing. If you are saying pi r or you are saying half of 2 pi r, they are the same thing. Okay. Now Krishna is saying the correct answer. Others, please try. Some mistake is there in this thing. If you remember, I have told you circumference is like going from the boundary. Suppose you are starting at this point, you have to walk on this complete boundary and you have to come back also if you have the path. So you can see you have traveled this curved path and this straight path. So the circumference is not only pi r. You are fine. You are saying, sir, if we half this circumference, we will get the circumference of disc. You are fine. But you have to consider this part also, that is the diameter. So the answer of circumference of a semicircular disc is given by half of 2 pi r, that is pi r, plus 2 r. That is your diameter. I hope it is clear to you how we have found the circumference of a semicircular disc. Please tell. Please confirm. Is it clear to you how we found the circumference of a semicircular disc? Now, coming back to semicircular arc, please tell me what is circumference of semicircular arc. In this case, we are not coming back. You can see there is no way to come back to A. We have to finish our journey at B only. So simple, the circumference of a semicircular arc is pi r, because there is no line which we are traveling back to A. I hope this simple difference is clear to you and you will keep this in your mind for future. Now, coming back to the area in both these cases is same, because area is the content. The content is same for both of them. Area is given by, please tell class, the area is given by area of complete circle was pi r square. So the area of semicircular arc is given by half of that. That is half pi r square, and here also half pi r square. That's it. I hope this is clear to everyone. Please confirm. Clear. Now we will start the questions from 11.1. Today, whichever questions are left, you can try on your own, and tomorrow you can ask your doubts so that we can discuss those. Bhavya, your video is on. Okay. Now, exercise 11.1. Okay. In this exercise, if we see question number 1, I hope question 1 is very simple for you to do. We can try question number 2 directly. Okay. Please hold 1 second. Question number 1. Okay. Number 2, sorry. Mrs. Kaushik has a square plot with the measurement as shown in the figure. So there is a square plot. Let me take the shape from you. One second. Okay. So she has a square plot like this. And then she, what are the measurements? The measurements are 25 meter length. And okay, it is same. It is square only. So this is the plot Mrs. Kaushik is having. She wants to construct a house in the middle of the plot. So please show the PDF of the book also on the screen. Okay. Ananya, tomorrow onwards I will try. Okay. Today time is not there to add that. Tomorrow I will make sure that the PDF is there. Okay. Till then you all can open your books. It is page number 171. Question number 2 I am trying. Okay. Open your books. Page number 171. Question number 2. Now, she wants to make a house in the middle. A garden is developed around the house. Find the total cost of developing a garden around the house at the rate of 55 per meter square. So let me make the house also in between. Inside, like this, she is trying to make a house. So this is her house. Okay. The dimension of house are given to you as 20 meters of length and 15 meters of breadth. So this is the house. We want to find the area of this garden. Plus, very simple question. How can you find this area of garden? Please tell. What should be the statement that we should write first? Tell me the statement that we will use. Area of garden will be given by, please tell, what is the statement that you will write? Before writing the question, before writing the equations, first we need to write a statement that will tell the story of the question. Yes, area of garden is given by area of plot minus area of house. And now we can put the formula. So area of garden we have to find. We have to put the formula of area of plot. And we all can see that plot is a square. If I call it as A, this is also A. I can say it is A square minus, if I call this 20 as L, this 15 as B, I can say L into B. So this way we have written the formula. And now let's put the values. A is 25 minus LB, that is 20 into 15. Class, please note one thing, that figure is very important in the case of these questions of mensuration, and proper labeling is also important. You should show what alphabet you have taken for the given dimension. Okay, I have shown you, I have taken A for the square plot, and I have taken L for the length of house and B as the breadth of house. I hope this point is clear to you, that figures are very important in these kind of questions. They make the question very easy to understand. Now, solving further, you will get 25 square is 625 minus 20 into 15. Very simple. 2 15s are 30. One more zero is there. So that is 300. Finally, you will get the answer as 325 meter square. So the land which is left for gardening is of area 325 meter square. Now they are asking the cost. They are saying, sir, how area of plot is 25 square? Saurabh, the plot is a square. If you see, square has same length and breadth. You can see it is 25 length and 25 breadth. And we all have seen area of square is given by side square or A square. Now it is clear to you, Saurabh? Now is it clear that area of square we have studied above is side square or A square? Very simple. Now we have to find the costing of gardening. The gardener is costing at a rate of, okay, development of garden. So developing 1 meter square of garden costs the owner rupees 55. So what will be the cost of developing 325 meter square Very simple. Unitary method, rupees 55 into 325. And very simple, let's multiply this. 25, 12, 16. So 1625 again. We will get the answer as 5, 7, 8, 7, and 1. The answer is rupees 17875. This is the cost that the person or the owner has to give to the gardener to develop the garden around the house. I hope this question is clear to everyone. The next question is a combination of two shapes again. The next question, question number 3, is a combination of two shapes. So please be very careful while solving the question. Question number 3. The shape of a garden is rectangular in the middle and semicircular at the ends. I hope all of you are having your books with you. Please see. In this question, there is a combination of figures. In the middle, there is a rectangle like this. You all have seen those fields in which you run. The running fields are like this only. They're like this and like this. The question is saying the shape of a garden is rectangular in the middle and semicircular at the ends. So we have two semicircles and one rectangle in total, which are combined together. Now, they are saying, find the area and perimeter of the garden. If they are saying that this complete length from this end to this end is 20 meters, and this complete length is given to you as 7 meters. Okay, now tell me, class, how will you find the perimeter first? Tell me. This is a rectangle in the middle. In the rectangle, we have length and we have breadth. In the circle, we have radius. Tell me, how will you find the value of L, the value of B, and the value of R? Because to find all these things, you need to find the value of L, B, and R. Can we say L is 20 meters? Please tell. Can we say the value of L is 20 meters? No, Krishna, we cannot say, because L is smaller, na? Just, beta, how you can say L is only this much? L is not 20 meter, beta. 20 meter is complete length from this end to this end. They are saying this much length is 20 meters. But we want is this length of rectangle. The question is how to find that. So try to understand that length is not equal to 20 meters. 20 meters is the complete measurement from one end to the other. So let's see what you can say about this. This is diameter, class. You can say this is diameter, class. Now see, this is the semicircle with you. If this is O, this complete is 7. What we can say about the radius? Please tell. If complete is a diameter as 7, what we can say about the diameter? The radius, sorry. So this portion is half of it, that is 7/2. So we can clearly say that the radius is 7/2 meters. If this is 7/2, what about this? Please tell me, what is this length? AO. This is also, please tell us, as we know, radius is same everywhere. This AO is also equal to 7/2 meters. Similarly, this will also be equal to how much? 7/2 meters. So if you see, in this end, we have 7/2. In this end, we have 7/2. Can't we find the length of rectangle now? The complete is 20, we want to find this length between these two. We can easily find now 20 minus this length minus this length will give us the length of rectangle. So L is given by 20, that is complete measurement, minus radius of first semicircle minus radius of second semicircle. Now, if you solve it further, you will get the answer as simple. Let me take the LCM as 2. 40 minus 7 minus 7. That is 40 minus 14 is 26 upon 2. Answer is 13 meters. First, tell me, I have found the value of L as 13 meters. Is it clear to you? Ananya is saying, sir, radius 35 by 10. Okay. And the length. Yes, yes. Ananya, it is correct. Okay. So we have to understand how to find the value of length. So we have found L as, let me write over here also, 13 meter. B is simple, 7 meters only. And R is 7 upon 2. So we have found all the things. Now let's move to the first part of the question. We have to find the perimeter. Tell me, what is perimeter? If I name the figure like this, A, okay, let me make a new figure once again. Better you name the figure properly. Like this, we have the figure. Let me call it A, B, C, D, E, and F. So we have to find perimeter, which is given by AB plus arc BEC plus CD plus arc DFA plus, I think done. Plus, should we add AD and CB also? Please tell, should we add these two also in the perimeter? Please tell, should we add these two also? No, because we have studied perimeter of any figure is only the outer portion, not the inside portion. So we have to consider the outside only. So AB will be counted, arc BEC will be counted, CD will be counted, arc DFA will be counted, and these two will not be counted. Now, let's fill the value one by one. What is the value of AB? Please tell. Plus, what is the value of AB? We have found already the value of AB is 13 meters. Plus, what is the value of arc BEC? What is the formula to find the length of arc BEC? Please tell. Just above, we have seen the formula of semicircular arc. We have to use that only. That is pi r plus, how much is the length of CD? CD is same, 13 meters plus, again, DFA is an arc of length pi r. Now, let's add the values by putting. So 13 plus 13 is 26 meters plus pi is pi r, and pi r is 2 pi r. Put the values. 2 into 22 by 7. The value of pi is 22 by 7 and r is 7 by 2. So guys, you can see 7, 7 will cancel. 2, 2 will cancel. And we are left with 26 meter plus 22 meters. And the answer is, yes, class, the answer is 2 meters. I hope the way we have found the perimeter is clear to everyone. Sir, this is also correct. What you have done, twice A plus B plus 2 into this thing minus 40. Yes, yes, Krishna, it is correct. What you have done is you have added all the perimeters and then you have subtracted the not needed part. That is also fine. It is correct. But why to increase the steps when we can make it simple easily? Hai na? So both are fine. It is your choice to go with. Now comes the area portion. This is very simple. Area we have to find of this field. Quite simple. Same way we will write the formula by taking the figure. You will write area of field is given by area of two semicircles plus area of rectangle. Because in area, we take the inside portion. We have to take the complete portion. This complete will come and this complete will come. Very simple. So area of two semicircles means twice into half pi r square plus L into B. Simply, you have to put the values in this formula and you will get the answer. So 2 into half pi r square means 2 and 2 will cancel. So pi r square plus L into B. Put the values and you get the answer. 22 by 7 into 7 by 2 into 7 by 2 plus 13 into 7. This you have to solve and you will get the answer. Okay, so with this, I'm stopping over here and you have to try the remaining question, that is question 1, 4 and 5, and tomorrow we will discuss if you have any doubts. Let me stop.